The NFL is in full panic mode after what the Louisiana Sheriff's Office just hit them with. Now, this is what real American patriots do. Earlier this week, Bossier Parish Sheriff Julian Whittington said his office will no longer be purchasing Ford products after the automaker expressed support for National Football League players' right to kneel in protest during the national anthem. In a letter sent to Hicks and Ford from the Ford Motor Company, Whittington states that recent events surrounding the NFL, its players and their audacity to thumb their collective noses at the American flag, the American military, as well as their obvious disdain for the profession of law enforcement in general, forces me to take a stand. Amen, Sheriff. In late September of this year, the Ford Motor Company, who is a major NFL sponsor, took it upon themselves to release a statement in response to the controversy over multiple rich spoiled ball tossers kneeling in disrespect towards our nation and our police officers while the national anthem was being sung prior to its games. The statement read, "We respect individuals' rights to express their views, even if they are not ones we share. That's part of what makes America great." Yahoo News reports. After President Trump trashed the NFL for allowing players to protest during the national anthem, NFL sponsors are slowly beginning to respond to the political firestorm. Some sponsors are issuing cautious statements that do not appear to take one side or the other, while others have unequivocally supported the players' right to protest. The majority of sponsors have remained silent. The NFL reaped $1.25 billion in sponsorship revenue last season. Its official league sponsors this season are Anheuser-Busch InBev, Barclaycard, Bose, Bridgestone, Campbell's, Castrol, Denon, DMI, EA Sports, Extreme Networks, FedEx, Ford, Frito-Lay, PepsiCo-owned, Gatorade, PepsiCo-owned, Hyundai, Intel, Marriott, Mars Candy, McDonald's, Microsoft, Nationwide, New Era, News America, Nike, Papa John's, PepsiCo, Procter & Gamble, Quaker, PepsiCo-owned, SiriusXM, Ticketmaster, Under Armour, USA, Verizon, Visa, and Zebra. Here's a running list of all the sponsors to issue statements on the anthem protest so far. Yahoo Finance has reached out to every sponsor and will keep updating it as they respond. Under Armour. Under Armour was the first official sponsor to issue any kind of statement in response to Trump's comments the night of September 22. The next day, Under Armour sent out a tweet that carefully avoided taking a side. The company said it stands for the flag and by our athletes for free speech, expression and a unified America. It appears to voice support both for the anthem and for the players protesting during the anthem. Ford. Ford, also an NFL sponsor, said on Monday, "We respect individuals' rights to express their views, even if they are not ones we share." Like Under Armour's statement, it avoids fully siding with the president or the player protests. But the latter part of the statement, "even if they are not ones we share," arguably implies Ford does not share the view of the player protests. Nike. On Monday morning, Nike became the third NFL sponsor to issue a statement, and arguably the first to take a clear position, it sided with the players. In a statement sent to the media, Nike said, "Nike supports athletes and their right to freedom of expression on issues that are of great importance to our society." Hyundai. Hyundai issued a statement on Monday afternoon that, like Nike, clearly sides with the players' right to protest. The statement says, "We stand for and respect individuals' freedoms to express their First Amendment rights in any peaceful manner in which they choose. We also stand for inclusion, freedom and all that represents those values." Anheuser-Busch InBev. On Monday night, a spokesperson for Anheuser-Busch InBev sent Yahoo Finance this statement, which appears to fall into the play it safe, neutral category along with Under Armour and Ford. "At Anheuser-Busch, we have a long heritage of supporting the institutions and values that have made America so strong. That includes our armed forces and the national anthem, as well as diversity, equality and freedom of speech. We proudly employ over 1,100 military veterans and we work every day to create an inclusive environment for all of our employees. Because only together can we achieve our dream of bringing people together for a better world. Bose. Bose sent out this statement on Monday night. Bose was founded in the United States, and our world headquarters is in Massachusetts, where it's been for over 50 years. It's now surrounded by several other Bose facilities, and at all of them, at all times, we proudly fly the American flag. It's a symbol of our great country which protects the freedom for every person to express their views. We respect that freedom, whether we agree with those views or not. In 2016 and 2017, the Bossier Parish Local Sheriff's Department purchased a total of 29 vehicles from Hicks and Autoplex, which amounted to $747,132. Not to mention all the future parts which will need to be purchased in the coming years. Those vehicles included 21 Ford Police Interceptors, 4 Ford Tauruses, a Ford F-150, 2 Ford F-250s and a Ford Explorer. Now here is the best part, Sheriff Whittington also that he would be sending copies of his letter to all of Louisiana's 63 other sheriffs and their respective departments. Although local media has reached out to both Hicks and Ford and Ford's corporate office for comment, as of yesterday neither had replied.